हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू भावनाथ ऑनलाइन एकेडमी। सो दिस इज द फोर्थ वीडियो इन द ऑर्डर ऑफ आवर पार्टनरशिप सीरीज। आई हैव ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड 3 वीडियोस, सो प्लीज मेक श्योर यू वॉच दोज 3 वीडियोस बिफोर वी गेट इनटू दिस वीडियो। एंड आई लिंक द सीरीज, दैट इज द प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ द पार्टनरशिप, इन द आई बटन हियर। यू कैन गो एंड क्लिक दैट एंड चेक दैट आउट। एंड ऑल्सो इन दिस वीडियो माई वॉइस माइट साउंड अ लिटिल बिट डल, इट वॉज बिकॉज इट वॉज नॉट इन द बेस्ट स्टेट ऑफ माई हेल्थ, सो प्लीज एडजस्ट विद दैट टू। सो यस गाइस, सो नाउ लेट्स गेट इन टू द वीडियो।
टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द फाइनल टॉपिक ऑफ पार्टनरशिप, that is the sale and conversion of partnership firms. So in a sale and conversion of a partnership firm, what happens is that first is sale. Sale means one partnership firm gets sold to some other company, and conversion means the partnership firm gets converted into another company. Okay, a company I mean. So the way you solve sale and conversion both for partnership firms are totally the same. Even for sale and partnership, all the steps will remain the same. So if you understand anyone, you will be able to do the both. Okay, so today we are going to see one of those sums only. In this sum, it's sale. Okay, so this is a sum of sale. So here in the question, what they have told you is that, so the question requirement here is that you have to prepare a realization account, and also you have to prepare the capital account of the partners. So these two are the requirements that you have to fulfill. So fulfilling that requirement, what you have to do, we have to see. So first, we'll start studying the question. So this is the question number 2. So here they are telling you that S and T are carrying on business as equal partners. So here they are telling you that S and T are two partners, and both the partners have a PSR of, that is your profit sharing ratio, of 1:1. Okay. And their balance sheet on 31st March will keep, this as 2011. 31st March 2011 stood as follows. So they have given you assets. In assets, you have a stock, you have stock, you have debtors, you have furniture, joint life policy, plant and building. And on the liability side, you have capital accounts, you have creditors, bank overdraft and bills payable. Okay. So here below, what they tell you is that, see, whenever they sell or convert, okay, a partnership firm to a company, it is not important that it either happens at the year end or at the year start. Okay, so year end or year start, it won't matter because all the figures will remain same. This is a sum where the sale of the partnership firm has happened in the middle of the year. So here they have told you that your balance sheet is given as on 31st March. We'll keep this as 2011, okay? 31st March 2011. But here, what has happened is that your sale, see, you can see here, the operations of the business were carried on till 30th September 2011. That means, like a partnership firm, it was carried out until only 30th September. So, 30th September is the date when your partnership firm is getting sold. Okay, just a second. So this is what they have told in the question. Also, they have told in the question that on this date, the balance sheet is given. So in the question, the balance sheet is given of this date, but we are selling the company on this date. Okay. So here they have told you what are the changes in the balance sheet that had happened between these 6 months. So they tell you that S and T, the two partners, have withdrew in equal amounts, half of the amount of profits made during the current period of 6 months, after 10% has been written off from building and plant, and 5% have been per annum written off on furniture. During the current period of 6 months, creditors were reduced by 50,000. Bills payable by 11,500, and bank overdraft by 75,000. They also tell you that the joint life policy, which was it was surrendered for 47,500. I hope you guys would have already attended my second class, in which I told you in detail about joint life policy and what it is. But here, Okay, for like just a recap, I would like to tell you that joint life policy is like a life insurance or a life policy that is taken for all the partners. Okay, so this joint life policy is like a asset to the partnership firm, because if any partner dies, okay, so when life, okay, when does this life insurance or joint life policy matures is that it is either when you die. If a partner, because it's a life insurance, right? So if a partner dies, they will get back the money. Or if the maturity period, suppose this joint life policy was taken for 10 or 15 years, if that 10 or 15 years matures, they will get back the amount. So these are the primary two ways on how joint life policy actually matures. But there is also another way. The another way is where, you know, what the partners of the firm can do is, if they think they don't need this joint life policy anymore, they can just say to the insurance company that they don't want this joint life policy and get their money back. So in the first two conditions, where there happens a death of a partner or the maturity of the joint life policy has come, in such term, whatever the amount you get from the insurance company, okay, in place of this joint life policy, that will be called your maturity value. Whereas, if the joint life policy that you have, you know, not de any partner has not died, nor the joint life policy has matured, but the partner themselves want to just close this joint life policy, in a case of such closure, okay, by the partners, this amount which we receive from the joint life policy will be called as surrender value. This I have already explained in detail in the previous classes. This was just a recap. Okay, so this joint life policy will be shown. This joint life policy, once again. So this joint life policy, once again, guys. So this joint life policy will be so shown as asset in the balance sheet, whereas if they get the maturity value or surrender value in against to such joint life policy, then this maturity value or surrender value will be taken as your assets realized. Okay, so just remember this point. Okay, joint life policy was surrendered for 47,500 on 31st September 2011. Stock was valued at 317,000 and debtors at 325,000. The other items remained the same as how it was on the balance sheet date. So what they have told you in the in this para right here is that they have told you that, see, so from 31st March 2011, our balance sheet was made, and after the balance sheet was made, for around 6 months, for around 6 months our business was running only. Okay, so that means till 30th September 2011 our business was running. So on 30th September 2011, or on the next day, that is your 1st October, we sold off our business. So now they have told you whatever the balance sheet items, whatever the difference was, okay, whatever the difference came in the balance sheet in these 6 months, they have told you in this paragraph. Okay, they have told you that on 30th September 2011, the firm was sold to its business ST Limited. So this partnership firm was sold off. Here they have told you that the value of goodwill was estimated at 5,40,000, and the remaining assets were valued on the basis of balance sheet. Okay, so here what this line is trying to tell us is that, one second, guys. Yes. Okay. So what this line is trying to tell you, the value of goodwill was estimated at 5,40,000, and the remaining assets were valued on the basis of balance sheet, is that, read the next line. ST Limited paid the purchase consideration equity shares of 10 each. That means they are trying to tell you in this line is that they are trying to tell you that, like this, you know, value of goodwill. Oh God. Yes, this value of goodwill. Here they are trying to tell you that whatever the purchase consideration was that, you know. So here they actually, what they tell you is that whatever the ST Limited was there, you know, to whom we sold the partnership firm. So to that firm, when we sold off, our goodwill in the company was 5,40,000, and the remaining assets, whatever they took away, was valued on the basis of balance sheet as on 30th September 2011. That means you have done so many clauses, so now you know what a purchase consideration is. So whenever a firm is taking away another firm, they need to pay something which is to the old firm. The new firm needs to pay to the old firm something known as purchase consideration. So the purchase consideration partnership chapter in our CA inter syllabus is mainly calculated using assets minus liabilities only. So whatever the net assets are, that only we take as purchase consideration. So for that only here they have told you that whenever you calculate the purchase consideration, take your goodwill as 5,40,000, and for the remaining assets, you know, they may take it at a higher price also, lower price also. Say what they have told you is they have taken at the same price which was appearing in the balance sheet of 30th September 2011. So on this date, whatever the balance sheet was appearing in that date only, they have taken this what do you say, they have taken this mean they have taken this as purchase consideration. Okay, they have also told you, so this purchase consideration they have to pay, you know, so if they take all these assets and all these liabilities, they have to pay to the old firm. They can either pay in the form of cash, or they can also pay it in the form of shares. Here they have opted an option of paying it back to the old firm in the form of shares. So the shares are valued of 10 each. So whatever amount comes, suppose your purchase consideration value is 3 lakh. That means here they have taken it in the form of shares. That means by 10 rupees. That means to the old firm, they have issued they have issued 30,000 shares to the old firm. Okay. So this is what they have told you, and they have told you finally that you have to prepare a realization account and partners capital account. Okay, so now what here is that, so when you read the sum, you understand one thing, that you have to prepare realization account. So to prepare the realization account, in the realization you will transfer assets and liabilities, right or not? Every one of you are going to transfer your assets and liabilities, right? So whenever you transfer these assets and liabilities, you know, you have to transfer all of these assets and liabilities at the value which was on the date of 30th September 2011 only. One second, please. The charge is low. Just a second. So whatever, whenever you are preparing a realization account, at that time here you will write assets. So this assets value, whatever you are going to write, right? This value should be of this value will not be the value which is shown in the balance sheet here. It should be of the value on the date of 30th September 2011 only. So for that, what we are going to do as a first step for us to find out the purchase consideration, also it is going to help us in preparing the realization account. Now first we are going to prepare the balance sheet on 30th September 2011, guys. So whatever the revaluations are there, all of that we'll take into account, and we will prepare a balance sheet on 30th September 2011. So this was about our question and the first step. Do you guys have any doubts until now? Please tell me, do you have any doubts until now? Any doubts? No, right? Okay. Just give me a second, guys. So now we'll start with preparing the balance sheet. Okay, it's not visible, right? Wait. Balance sheet. We are going to prepare balance sheet asset. It's going to be 30th September 2011. Okay, so we are going to prepare a balance sheet now. So whatever the figures are given in the balance sheet and whatever the realization figures are, you have to take that into consideration. Okay. So now let's start. I'm sorry if I'm like really going slow on the speed. Please adjust. Okay. So first asset that we have is stock. So we'll first write stock here on the balance sheet side. We'll write stock. Okay. So what we are going to do is we are going to go down, and we are first going to just mark whatever the assets are that had to be revalued. So here they gave for building and plant. They have given for furniture, and on liabilities they give creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft. Okay. So now if we look down, we don't have any. We have, right? Wait. I just left. Okay, here it is down. You have for joint life policy, you have for stock, and you have for debtors. Okay. So, stock here is revalued at 3,17,000 rupees. So, we'll write the amount of 3,17,000. Next, what you have is debtors. So, debtors also, they have revalued at 3,25,000. Okay. Next, what you have is furniture. So, furniture, the value they have told that it has to be depreciated by 5%. Okay. The furniture value is 75,000. In that 75,000, if we do a depreciation of 5%, how will you do? So it will be 75,000 into 5% into 6 by 12, guys, because these for this 5% is per annum. Now here we are only preparing balance sheet after 6 months. So the asset will also be depreciated for 6 months. So please tell me, what is 75,000 into 5% into 6 by 12? It is going to be 1,875. I think, just let me know if it's right. So it's going to be 75,000 minus 1,875, which is going to be 73,125. Okay. So the next asset that we have is the joint life policy. So here, what has happened, what they have done in the book is that, okay, so here in the end, I will tell you why I have not taken joint life policy as assets in this, okay? So for now, just ignore that there is something known as joint life policy. I'll tell you about it in the end, why we have not taken it as a asset here. Yes? Okay, fine. So now we are going to take plant. So plant is 1,72,500 minus... the depreciation is going to be first. Now I'll tell you one point first. The first point is that joint life policy was actually surrendered on 30th September 2011. Okay, so joint life policy was not there. Okay, it was not there in the firm at all on 30th September 2011. So thereby you cannot put this as assets. Suppose if furniture was sold off on 30th September, you will not put furniture on this balance sheet, right? Likewise, joint life policy was also surrendered. In a way, it was sold away. So you will not show that in the balance sheet now. Okay. So that was about joint life policy. Now, plant 1,72,500 minus depreciation for at the rate 10%. Okay, so it will be 1,72,500 into 10% into 6 by 12, which is going to be 8,625. Okay, so the amount here will be 1,63,875. Next, you have the last asset that you have here is building. So building worth 9,10,000 minus depreciation. Minus depreciation here again 10%. 9,10,000 into 10% into 6 by 12 will be 45,500. If you do this, you will get amount of 8,64,000. Just a second, guys. Yes, 500. So can someone total me what is the total of balance sheet, and can someone, I mean, total of asset side, and tell me? So the total of balance sheet is going to be 17 lakh. I mean, asset side is going to be 17,43,500. Okay, now we'll start with the liability side. So liability side, as of now, we will not write the capital accounts. We'll start with creditors. So creditors, they have told you that it was reduced by 50,000. That means it will be 3,27,500 minus 50,000, which is going to be 2,77,500. Next, you have bills payable. Bills payable was reduced by 11,500. That means it will be 1,50,000 minus 11,500. So bills payable will be 51,000. The same way, you also have bank overdraft. Okay, so bank overdraft is reduced by 75,000. Okay, so one second. Okay, so bills payable, it was actually 62,500 minus 11,500. Okay, so bank overdraft is 1,50,000. I just made a mistake there. Bank overdraft is 1,50,000 minus, here you are going to do minus 75,000. which is going to be 75,000. Okay, so this was all the figures here also. Then means it should be a total of 17,43,500. So if you do so, the balancing figure will be the capital accounts. If you do so, the balancing figure is going to be your capital accounts. If you try to balance this, you will get a balancing figure of 13,40,000. You will get a balancing figure of 13,40,000. Okay. So in such case, your capital of S and T will be there. Here, don't do a mistake. Everybody will do a mistake here. What they'll do is they'll see, okay, the ratio is equal partner here. So they will do 13,40,000 divided by 2, and for S they will put that 50%, T they'll put that 50%. Like that, you must not do. Here also you can see it is not in the ratio of 1:1. Okay, so I've seen many people doing this mistake. Please don't do that. Okay, this is not in the ratio of 1:1 here. So it is not important that if your ratio is equal, your capital balance will also be equal only. Okay, so this we will have to find out what their capital balance is going to be. So for that, what we are going to do, that we know that it is a total of 3,40,000, but for S how much and for T how much, we have to do a working note. We will write that working note as working note number one here. Okay, you can write calculation of capital, working note number one. So here you have to find out the capital. Okay, so here what has happened is, here they have given you one line where they told you that S and T withdrew in equal amounts half the amount of profits made during the current period of 6 months. So here what they have told you is that, so from the start, that is from 31st March 2011 to 30th September 2011, in this 6 months period, there was some profit made. In the profit which was made, half was taken away, that is in equal amounts. Okay, withdrew equal amounts, half the amount of profit. So suppose if profit was made for 50,000, they took away 25,000. Okay, 25,000. Okay, so whatever their share of profits was, from their share of profits they took away half the amount. Okay, in equal amounts. Okay, so half the amount they had taken away. So now I'll show you a simple method of calculating profits. So what you can do is, you can take your, what your, what your closing balance here is. So here your closing balance is 13,40,000. Your opening balance was 13 lakh. Okay. So see this account. Okay. One second, guys. Okay. So suppose this is the amount you are going to talk about capital here. Here, what was your opening balance? Your opening balance was 13 lakh. In that 13 lakh, what was your closing balance? Your closing balance was 13,40,000. Here, what they have told you is, you have also made profit. Suppose if the profit is X, what they have told you is, the partners, you know, the partners have made some drawings. The partners have made some drawings. Your opening balance was 13 lakh. Your closing balance was 13,40,000. Okay. Here, profit, if profit was X, what your partners did was, they made a drawings of half the amount. That means X by 2. They made a drawing of X by 2. Is this equation clear to you guys? I hope it is. Okay. If you have doubts, you can ask me. So here now we will try to solve this equation. Okay. So we will write 13 lakh plus X equal to 13,40,000 plus X by 2. So it is going to be, so this will become 26,80,000 plus X by 2. Here 13 lakh plus X. If you multiply this, you will get 26 lakh here plus 2X, which is equal to 26,80,000. Plus X. So now if you solve this, you will get the equation like this, which is going to be 80,000 plus X equal to 2X. So now if you do this, you will get the amount as X equal to 80,000. Okay. So your X, what was your X? Your X was your profit. So this is nothing but your profit amount. Are you clear till this? Are you able to understand? Okay, so I hope you guys don't have any doubt here. If you have, you can please ask me. Sorry. Yes, so what was I saying? So we know that what is the profit now. So here now what we are going to do is that, so usually what is your formula? So usually, what will be your formula? How is your capital account actually made? So your capital account will be nothing but, I mean your closing balance of capital account will be nothing but opening balance of capital account plus whatever the profits is during the year minus the drawings. So this is the normal equation how you find out your closing balance. It will be opening balance plus profit minus drawing. The same thing we are going to do now. Okay, here we'll do for S and then we are going to do for T here. So yes, opening balance as you can see here is 6,40,000 and for D and for T it is 6,60,000. So this is going to be 6,40,000. So for T it is 6,60,000. So then they got a profit. Okay, so how much was the profit the firm made? Thank you so much for the concern, Roshni, by the way. Yes. So the profit is 80,000. So here you have to remember one thing that the partners had a ratio, profit sharing ratio of 1:1. That was an equal ratio. So S will get a profit of 40,000 and T will also get a profit of 40,000. Okay, so this is how their profit, the profit for 6 months will be distributed between them. Okay, then at the end they have taken drawings. Drawings also, so drawings here, how much will be the drawings here? You can find out. So the drawings here will be 40,000, right? X by 2 means 80,000 by 2, which is going to be 40,000. So in this 40,000 also, they have here told you that they withdrew in equal amounts only. So they told that they have withdrew in equal amounts only. So there is no partner who withdrew more and another partner who withdrew less. Both people have withdrew, I mean, have taken a drawing of same amount only. So if they both had to take a drawing of same amount, that means they had to take half half in the drawings, right? So one partner would have taken 20,000 drawing means another partner would have also taken a 20,000 drawings only. So here your drawings would be minus 20,000 minus 20,000. So now here we'll be able to find out the closing balance. So closing balance of S and T, can you please tell me? Closing balance of S will be 6,60,000 and closing balance of T will be 6,80,000. Very good, Shruti. Okay, so this is our closing balance. Now if you add these both, it will come up to 13,40,000. You can just verify that. Okay, so here we can write 6,60,000, 6,80,000. Okay, so I hope until this it is clear. So our first step that we had to prepare balance sheet for doing our realization account and for finding out our purchase consideration, we have already done that. Okay, so the first step that you had to do balance sheet is done. Okay, so now we are going to move on to the step number two. So according to the question requirements, we are doing this. Okay, so the next step what we are going to do is we are going to do calculation of purchase consideration. Okay, wait a second. Okay, yes, we'll find out the calculation of purchase consideration so that when we are preparing a realization account, we can also just throw in this figure there. Okay, so what is your purchase consideration? Your purchase consideration is nothing but assets minus liability, and whatever the figure you get, that will be your purchase consideration. Here, what is your assets amount? Your assets is 17,43,500. 17,43,500. 43,500. But here, one thing you have to remember that they have told you that when they took over the assets, you know, the value of goodwill was estimated to be 5,40,000. Okay, so that also you have to take into consideration while calculating your PC. So it will be plus goodwill amount 5,40,000. So your total assets value is going to be 17 lakh. Sorry. So your total amount, assets amount will be 17 lakh. Once again, I'll just do that. I don't have a calculator right now. Can someone just calculate and tell me the assets amount? Till that, I'll write your liabilities. So in liabilities, you will definitely not take your So it is 22,83,500. Okay, thank you. Yes. So liabilities, you will only take this liabilities, right? So you'll not take your capital and all. That will not come under the liabilities which you calculate under net mean purchase consideration. So it will be 2,77,500 plus 51,000 plus 75,000. Okay, so if you do that, it will come up to an amount of 4,03,500. So if you do so, can someone tell me what is our purchase consideration? So it is going to be 18,80,000. So this is going to be our PC. Okay, so this was how we calculated our purchase consideration. I hope you guys don't have any. One second. So I hope you guys don't have any doubt in this. Okay. One second. So this was about our calculation of PC. One second, guys. Yes. Okay. So now that we have done our balance sheet, found out our PC also, the last step we have to do is fulfill the requirement of the questions. Now we are going to prepare our realization account and the capital account of partners, and then that's it. Our sum is going to be over. Also, the sum which we are doing now has been asked in the past examinations also, and it's also a very, very important question. Okay. So now we'll start with preparing our realization account. You can prepare the columns. Just give me a minute, okay? So now we have started. So now we are going to enter into doing our realization account. From this, I think you all have been practiced. Now it's going to be really easy for you. Okay, so we'll prepare realization account. So realization account, what is the first step that we will do? We'll transfer all our assets and liabilities. Okay, so that will be our first step. That is a Swachh Balance Sheet Abhiyan. Okay, so first we'll start with stock. Our stock is 3,17,000. Then we have debtors. Debtors is 3,25,000. Then we have furniture. Furniture is 73,125. Then we have plant. Plant is 1,63,875. And finally, you have building. Building is 8,64,500, and what that's all your assets. And now we'll transfer liabilities here. So creditors, you have 2,77,500. Then you have bills payable, which is 51,000. Then you have bank OD. So bank OD is 75,000. Okay, so now that we have transferred everything into realization account, can someone tell me what will be our next step? Let me see how well you have understood this concept. What will be our next step? Anybody who can answer me what will be our next step in the realization account? Whatever you know, if it's wrong also, it's completely okay. Realization profit? No. You still have to do your assets realized and liabilities realized. But here, since we are not doing that, we have to write a purchase consideration. Very good. So usually what you do in purchase consideration is that you directly write your company name in purchase consideration. But here in the sum, it is quite different. Here you have to see that they have told you that the purchase consideration will be in equity shares of 10 each. It's going to be in equity shares of 10 each. So whenever you write your purchase consideration, you have to write equity shares of SL Limited. You have to write equity shares of SL Limited, and you have to write your purchase consideration amount. Okay, which is going to be 18,83,000. Please remember this one. Okay, this is one different point. Okay, once you write this, the final step is that you have to close down your realization account. So tell me, what is the realization profit or loss? So here the total is 22. I mean, so the total is 22,83,500. Here also it will be 22,83,500. So here we get a realization profit. What happened? Everybody's doing this very slowly, is it? So here you will get, very good, I got the answers. Okay, so it will be 5,40,000. It is going to be 5,40,000. You have to split it as, you have to write two partners capital account profit. So it will go to S&T. So for both the PSR ratios, 1:1, so equal only. So it is going to be 2,70,000 and 2,70,000. Hope the realization account is clear to you all. And the final step that we have to do is your partner's capital account. Just give me a second. I'll clear a little bit of the area here. Okay. So now we are going to prepare partner's capital account. So partner's capital account, you can prepare your columns first. Okay. So we have S here, T here, and S here, T here. Okay. So first we'll write our buy balance brought down, which is 6,60,000 and 6,80,000. This I have taken up from this balance sheet here. Okay. So from this balance sheet I have taken it here. So it is 6,60,000 and 6,80,000. And also here we have to write our realization profit. By realization profit, it is going to be 2,70,000 and 2,70,000. Okay. So after this, so whatever amount is remaining, you know, that is the amount these partners are going to get. It is going to be nothing but your purchase consideration only. Here also it will come as their balancing figures, which they are going to get. Okay. So it will be shares in SL Limited. Okay, so always remember, whatever balancing figure you get, that will be your purchase consideration only. So it will be that figures only. You have to write your purchase consideration. You have to write it, name it as shares in SL Limited. So here, if you do, you will get 9,30,000. And this side, you will get 9,50,000. If you add this both, you will get 18,80,000. Very good, Shruti. So this was the whole sum, guys. So I hope you understood each and every part of the sum. I hope you don't have any doubts. If you have doubts, please ask me. Okay, please ask me if you have any doubts. I'll wait for 1 minute. Also, few people, profit and drawings. See, either you can write it as buy balance brought down. You can write the old figure and write it as profit and drawings. Here, the figure which we have written, you know, 6,60,000, 6,80,000. Already, whatever profit and drawings was there, it has already been adjusted. Okay, so here, since the profit and drawings has already been adjusted in the capital account, you don't need to do that again. Can you explain joint life policy point alone? Okay, just a second. So what is the joint life policy? Joint life policy is nothing but your life insurance. Joint life policy is nothing but life insurance. So this life insurance, when will it mature? It will either mature when a person dies or when the life period has been ended. That means the insurance period has got ended. Okay. Okay, so that is when a life insurance policy will mature. That is just like a joint life policy. So joint life policy will either mature when one of the partner dies or when the period of the joint life policy, if it is taken for 20 years, if the 20 years has matured, the joint life policy will also mature. Okay, so that is joint life policy. And when this joint life policy matures, you will get some money from the insurance company. So joint life policy is like your asset in the partnership firm. So whatever money you receive against the joint life policy, okay, as the maturity value or surrender value, it is going to be nothing but like your assets realized. How if you sell a stock, you get money in return, you know, like that only. If your joint life policy matures, you will get money in return. Here the money which you have got in return surrenders was 47,500. Here they have told you that joint life policy surrendered was 47,500. Okay, since surrender value, usually why we didn't take here, because this was actually done before the old balance sheet was already made. Okay, now if this was surrendered amount was there and we had to prepare here, if suppose it was given in a normal balance sheet, and if you wrote this joint life policy, this amount in the asset side, in the realization account, here you will write assets realized, right? You will write buy cash and assets realized. Here you will have to write joint life policy, whatever the assets realized amount is, that is 47,500. This will be your asset amount. This will be your realized amount. Here also in the question, they have taken assumption. In the book, when they have solved, they have taken assumption that joint life policy has already been adjusted with whatever the company had cash. okay, whatever company's cash was there, with that they have adjusted, they have told us. So that's why I have also not taken this into consideration. A clear explanation on that point I'll give you later. But for now, just remember, joint life policy we have not taken in the sum. And also, this if you read that, if you go to your ICA material and read, in the last, after the sum has been completed, they have given a note that joint life policy, whatever the surrendered value was, 47, that is 47,500 was there, it has been already adjusted. So we do not take that into account itself. So they have just taken assumption like that. In the exam, you can also just write assumption and come. Okay.
So yes guys, we have come towards the end of the video. If you like this video, please do like, share, comment and subscribe to the channel. Also meet you in the next video guys. Bye bye.